She's got it. But I'd love to know with $75 million spent. I think that's a nice story. I think people would be happy to see that you've invested all that money.
I guess, you know, that's a good question. Kevin and I do talk about this from time to time.
Because honest to God, people say they spend all this money all the time. We don't know if it's true or not.
I'm going to do this because... Well, you probably can't. I wish I had brought the big...
You want this?
Could we bring that down? That might help a little bit. Because here's one of the things that if you're... If you're
Billy makes a move towards the whiteboard.
Go ahead, you want the whiteboard.
This is what I do at Trinetown. We've just extended this by about an hour.
No,
but...
I've got a conference call.
I'm going to hold this. You're taping this. So, I mean, I hold this up. And basically, to Chazzy's question, because it really is a good one. If you're coming in off of Route 18, and Chazzy, I think you indicated to Jeremy you drove past it recently, and so you see the wall and the beautiful
wall and the vegetation,
nice little New England countryside with the beautiful trees and the orchards.
And you say, well, that's very nice, but I don't think that's $75 million. And you say, well, you're right. And if it were, he and I would both be fired. So what you do is, well, just come in a little bit further. And keep coming in, and come in for that first half a mile of road that you'll see has been widened and has also been landscaped and all the improvements that
have been upgraded to full build out.
Right, and all the utilities laid and everything else, including, you know, the data lines and that kind of stuff that weren't there before, I might add. And when you come in there and come up and you see, frankly, a whole brand new road that's been, now this is an older map than what we actually have there, but you've got what's called Shea Memorial Grove that has been constructed.
Memorial Grove Avenue.
Memorial Grove Avenue.
Shea is the road that comes in, and then when you
when
you get to Tri-Town's office, you make a right onto Memorial Grove Ave, which takes you down into our first residential village.
Right, and that'll take you to the first pods of infrastructure that have been created to support
that. And then when you get to the end of Shea Memorial, we've put in a whole nother stretch of road called Parkview, which includes a Commonwealth Ave type of road, meaning you drive up one side, drive down the other, with an 80-foot park in the middle. And literally, the stone walls, the lights, the fire hydrants,
that's right,
they're all in. And on top of that, we have rough graded 20, 30 acres of land down there for residential development. We've also rough graded 10 acres of commercial property.
That's right.
So again, if you come in, and we'd more than happy to drive you guys through it whenever you'd like, I think when you get the touch and feel and see the quality, the sidewalks with the green, the green strip and the granite curbs and the high-end lights and the trees and the, you know, all this stuff that we have invested to date, I think it's not very difficult to start understanding that where the money's gone. And we also haven't talked about the marketing center. I mean, if you go in, you're also at that corner of Shea and Memorial Grove Ave. You're going to see a brand new 2,200 square foot marketing center that's not a trailer like traditional residential builders, you know, use. It's a brand new building that we constructed and have furnished out. And again, I think it's just another sign of our commitment and the permanence of it. And just on a side note, I mean, that building was also built that when our retail center opens up, the Village Center will move down to there, and we're actually donating that building to the Patriot Squadron for their museum. So, but again, the advantage that we think we have on the commercial side is if you are within the form, we're a different zoning code than anywhere in Massachusetts. It's called a form-based zoning code. And a form is an office building, a form is retail, a form is a townhome. And they're all on our website. It's about a page and a half that deals with heights and setbacks and coverage ratios and parking ratios. If you are within that form, you're an as-of-right use, and statutorily, Tri-Town has 90 days in which to approve your site plan.
Is there anybody in that pipeline now?
Is there anyone in that pipeline now? On the commercial side, no. But again, we do have commercial interest, people who we are working through for a wellness center actually for a small 20,000 square foot building that is a family business. There's the movie studio piece as well. We've had two cinema groups, not movie studio groups, but actual cinemas, come and express very strong interest.
What's the central point these days in discussions with the Navy?
Oh boy. The biggest problem we have in talking about things is that it is a negotiation, and it's hard to say a whole lot about stuff that is a negotiation. Obviously, we've got, you know, we are discussing the TriTap, the approaches forward. And, you know, I think Jack and, or John, I should say, Jack and John, you know, in the interest of us working those things forward, you know, we probably should leave it at that. But, you know, I would expect that in the next couple of weeks, there'll be a lot more sound. Is that fair?